Hi viewers, you are all welcome to my channel. Viewers, today's talk is focused on who will head India's destiny in the next 5 years after the election. I mean to say, who will be the next Prime Minister of India? Is it Modi ji or Rahul ji? I am analyzing the chart without any biasness and giving my reading. I hope I will be very accurate astrologically. Viewers, the next general elections are to be conducted in the month of April 2019 with transit Saturn in the 8th house and Rahu in the 2nd house from the ascendant Taurus in the horoscope of the Independence India. Transit Jupiter, viewers, is in the 7th house, which assures a favorable rule to the nation for the next 5 years. Let me tell you, the 9th and 10th Lord Saturn will move into Capricorn in January 2020. And this movement from Capricorn onwards will be highly beneficial for the nation, both in terms of finance and also for peace and progress. Though transit Rahu in the 2nd and transit Ketu in the 8th are disturbing factors astrologically, the aspect of Jupiter on Taurus is a blessing for India's peace, progress and economic growth. Election is round the corner. People are asking astrologically, who will be the next Prime Minister? It is a question bothering the whole nation. If the Bharatiya Janata Party attains the required majority, it is only Modi ji who will be the next Prime Minister, as his horoscope is bustling with Raj Yoga combination. If it is other party, then there will be no doubt Rahul ji will emerge as the Prime Minister candidate. Even his horoscope is also bustling with Raj Yogas, which can make him a Prime Minister candidate. Viewers, as the two major parties contesting are the BJP and the Congress, a study and analysis of their horoscope is very important. Let me tell you, if we see the Rashi chart of Bharatiya Janata Party, one can find ascendant Gemini, where at present Rahu is transiting for the coming 18 months, which has changed position from Cancer to Gemini. In the 3rd house, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn and Rahu in Leo, in which Mars is retrograde, Jupiter is retrograde and Saturn is retrograde. Moon in Bharatiya Janata Party's Rashi chart is placed in Scorpio, a sign owned by Mars. Mercury and Ketu, they are occupying Aquarius, Kumbh Rashi, and Sun is in Pisces, a sign owned by Jupiter. Venus is in Taurus. Viewers, this is a view of BJP's Rashi chart. What I can feel, BJP is running Moon Dasha from April 11th, 2019. The Bhukti of Mars is going to change the BJP's complete scenario after the April 2019. It is this time that BJP has faced tough competition in Karnataka, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh. The reason behind is the Bhukti of Mars is not favorable. And Chhattisgarh, though the popular vote remained almost the same as in the parliamentary election of 2014. The Mars Bhukti indicates a change in BJP's entire composition as far as BJP's Rashi chart is concerned in the coming time after April 2019. If we see, viewers, the Congress Party's chart, the ascendant is Capricorn, in which Ketu was transiting in the past 18 months, and on 7th of March, Ketu has transited from Capricorn to Sagittarius. Ketu is placed in Pisces, a Jupiterian sign. Jupiter is retrograde in Gemini, where Rahu is at present transiting. Mars in Cancer, retrograde. Saturn in Leo, retrograde. Rahu and Moon in Virgo. And Mercury in Scorpio. Venus and Sun in Sagittarius. This is a view of Congress Party's Rashi chart. Viewers, Congress Party is currently in Jupiter Dasha, Venus Bhukti. April 2nd, 2018 to December 4th, 2020. The time period will run. The Congress has won three major elections and supported JDS in the Karnataka coalition in Venus Bhukti. The party's chart indicates, although they will have a very tough time in the month of April and May, but there is mega change await in the party's destiny after May. Although the transit of Rahu over their sixth house, where Jupiter is retrograde, and Ketu from the 12th house, where Venus and Sun is placed, indicates there will be tough fight in the election, and at the last minute there may be suddenly equation may change the other way also. But the trend also indicate after 16 months the Congress Party will once again come into a prominent position and form their own government in a big way. Viewers, let us see the horoscope of Rahul Gandhiji, the Congress president. Let me tell you, the Congress president will be in Mars Dasha, Moon Bhukti, up to April 11th, 2019, and will run the Dasha of Rahu next. Rahu is such a planet which gives sudden elevation to the highest power corridor or success. At the same time, Rahu also creates obstacles. The Mars Dasha is on the ending phase, and Rahu is on the beginning phase. This indicates a major change in the Rahul Gandhi's destiny after 11th April 2019. This period, viewers, comes under Dasha Chidram. His moon will be caught in the Rahu Ketu axis from 7th March 2019 onwards. Saturn will be in Sagittarius or natal moon, though the distance between them is 22 degrees. Two cruel transiting planets on either side of the natal moon can make him restive and disturb, although there is more positive things to come. Rahu is in Saturn's sign and Saturn is Nicha or debilitated. This period is therefore going to bring lots of changes in the coming time for Rahul Gandhi politically also. Viewers, Rahul Gandhi is running Mars Dasha, which is the Dasha of the Yoga Karaka. But Uttara Kalamitra, an astrological text, says Mars owns the fourth house from the ascendant, then there will be a big change in the destiny at the end phase of Mars Dasha. It may give power, position and success suddenly in a big way. Viewers, at the beginning of Rahu, it says Rahu can lift a person to the highest power corridor suddenly when it starts its Dasha. If Rahu occupies the 5th or the 9th from the Dasha Lord, then it's become very auspicious. Here Rahu occupies the 9th from Dasha Lord Mars. Kumbh Rahu is generally compared to a changing phase of the destiny. Rahul Gandhi's Dasha Lord will be transiting by Rahu at the time of election, which indicates there will be very tough fight in this election, and at the final stage the equation will suddenly change and there will be some negative impact. There is no doubt Rahul Gandhi will head India's destiny. That is, after 16 months there will be again equations which will make him heading India's political destiny. Viewers, let us see the chart of Narendra Modi ji. Narendra Modi ji is in Moon Dasha, Mercury Bhukti, from September 4th, 2018 to February 11th, 2020. He was sworn in as the Prime Minister in 2014 in Moon Dasha, Rahu Bhukti. We started on April 2014. The Nicha or debilitated position of the moon did not hinder his success, but made him the Prime Minister of India with a big majority. The present Bhukti Lord Mercury is exalted with the Sun and Rahu aspecting him. Viewers, Mercury is in the 11th house from the moon. This Dasha is of Dasha Madhipati or the 10th Lord Moon, and the Bhukti is of Bhagyadipati or the 9th Lord Mercury, and is very, very favorable Rajyog for Narendra Modi ji, which will give him success after tough situations, conditions which may come suddenly. He will emerge as a surprise success. The period for the BJP although being not favorable, the party may have to join hands with others to form the government. The trends indicate his personal horoscope is bustling with Rajyog, and he will emerge as a success in the month of April. Viewers, if we go a little bit detail about Narendra Modi's chart, it has many Rajyogas which can give him grand success. He is running the Dasha of 10th Lord Moon, who prominently signifies high power and position. Viewers, the moon is well placed in the 5th from his own house and in the 2nd from the ascendant. The Bhukti Lord Venus is in the 10th Kendra from Dasha Lord, as well as in the 11th from the ascendant in the house of gains. Mantreshwara extols Nichabhanga Rajyoga as one that give rise to a ruler with mass appeal. Modiji's Nichabhanga moon has already proved its blessing. Further, a benefic Jupiter will be transiting his Dasha Lord moon at the time of election. It is often observed that good results occur when natural benefic transit the Dasha Lord. All this astrological indication point to a powerful return for Narendra Modi after a tough fight with the help of coalition. And it is also true that after 16 months, there will be a lot of challenges, and sometime he may lose power, and at that time, again, the Rahul Gandhi may emerge as a destiny of India. Viewers, before concluding my talk, let me tell you, in the coming election, the role of a lady candidate will be very important, and there are chances that sometime the India's destiny may be ruled by a lady candidate after April 2019, or the things will be a surprising also. Unexpected person may rule India also. Probabilities are also there. Thank you. Bye.
काम आते हैं हमें तड़पाते कि चिट्ठी आती है ये पूछे जाती है कि घर कब आओगे कि घर कब आओगे लिखो कब आओगे कि तुमने ये घर
Oh.
संदेश आते हैं हमें तड़पा।